Welcome to the February edition of Tax Updates by PwC Turkey. The very first item on our list is the tax communique on online advertising fees. Turkish companies who purchase online advertising from foreign providers, they may want to take note. The tax authority recently amended the legislation. According to the new rule, you are now required to deduct 15% income tax from your payments to the foreign providers. The issue here is, and we talked before on this, the rules under tax treaties require physical presence before business income of a foreign company can be taxed in Turkey. If the foreign provider makes transactions with Turkish customers without physical presence in Turkey, and if there is a tax treaty in place, the income cannot be taxed in Turkey. Now, the Turkish tax authority decided that they were going to tax everybody, including those who are resident in countries that have tax treaty with Turkey. So the taxpayers figured out, hey, the tax treaty already told us the rule, no physical presence, no income tax. And this is the sort of clarification the taxpayers wanted to see, hoped to see in the communique to come from the tax authority. But the tax authority said, yes, that was long time ago. Today we have the internet. We have a lot of commerce being done with no physical presence, and the tax law needs to move with the times. This is the position of the Turkish tax authority, and the position was confirmed also in the communique in February. So the short of the story is, all foreign providers are required to pay 15 lira tax for every 100 lira they charge to Turkish customers for placement of online advertising. If you are purchasing online advertising from a foreign provider, you are required to deduct the tax from payment and remit it to the tax authority. If your contract with the foreign provider says that the agreed fee is to be paid net, without deduction of taxes, this new tax is going to be an additional cost for you. And as you are going to gross up the service fee for taxes, the amount of tax you are going to pay to tax office will not be 15, but 17.6% of the amount you pay to the foreign provider. So in this very happy note, I'm now moving to the VAT communique number 23. Perhaps you are still receiving expense invoices related to last year. You are incurring VAT on these invoices and you would like to claim this input tax. Can you do so? To provide some context here, the right to recover input tax only arises when there is an invoice issued to support that claim. So you need to obtain the invoice before you can make the input VAT claim. In addition to this, there is a time limit for claiming this input tax. Under the old rule, the right to deduct the input tax was limited with the year in which supply takes place. This was often an issue. For example, you receive a service in year one, but the invoice is issued in year two, you lose the right to recover the input VAT you incur. Last year, the government made an amendment to the VAT law and said that starting from 2019, you can claim the input tax not only in the year of the supply, but also in the following one. So you have one additional year before you lose your deduction right. All good for now. Now the biggest uncertainty here was the treatment of 2018 invoices that we received in 2019. Are we subject to the old rule or the new rule? This communique in February clarifies that the new rule is applicable and therefore you can claim the input VAT in 2019. Another novelty in 2019 is the VAT relief on bad debts you incurred. You have made a supply to a customer, but you were not paid the price. With this new provision, you may be able to claim relief for the VAT you paid to tax authority when you issued the invoice to your customer. There are of course conditions for this. In fact, we are looking at three conditions here. Number one, you must have already accounted for the VAT on the supply and paid it to tax office. Number two, the receivable must qualify worthless receivable in accordance with the rules set out under Tax Procedural Code, and you must have written off the invoice in your accounts. so the relief does not apply to all unpaid invoices. Number 3, the buyer must also adjust the input VAT that he deducted on the concerned purchase. If you are ticking all of the 3 boxes, you are allowed to recover the VAT you paid to tax authority on the unpaid invoice. This means that you will be reducing the output VAT on your return, and correspondingly, the customer has to reduce his input VAT in his return in the same period. In practice, it might be challenging to ensure this reciprocity, especially if you are in dispute with the counterparty. We will see how this will work. Another important development in February was the communique number 24, bringing favorable amendments in relation to VAT refund procedures. Taxpayers who file VAT refund requests will be able to receive 50% of the refund in 10 days, subject to certain conditions. If you are claiming VAT refund, it's something to check out. This is the end of our time. Thank you for tuning in, and we look forward to next month.